Hey guys, Sandy from Overland Explorers here. Katie and I are about to embark on about a 6-month journey around Australia. But before we go and get this thing dirty, we really wanted to give you an in-detail look and walkthrough of the car. We're going to break it up into a few different parts for you guys. The first part's going to be performance and exterior accessories. Then we're going to walk around the back and have a look at the roof, some of our camping setup, and really focus on the touring at the back. And then finally, we're going to show you a few shots inside the car as well. We've done a lot of cool stuff to this thing, built up over the years, and really excited to get to show you it. Hopefully you get some ideas for your own build. So let's have a look what's powering this thing. We started off with a upgraded turbocharger. This vehicle comes with a 3-litre turbo diesel from factory, but we wanted to step it up to help sort of move some of the weight around on it because it's quite heavy. So we've got a ProCharge Stage 2 high flow turbo. We then focused on cooling it down and replaced the factory top mount cooler with a Process West front mount intercooler. We also added the ECU shop radiator support bracket. Because we replaced the front mount cooler for the factory top mount, we added a Prado rocker cover to give it a nice finishing touch. And then to tie it all together, we took it down to Campbellfield Automotive. We got a HKS ECU put in it, and then they dyno tuned it for us as well. It's pushing about 185 horsepower at the rear wheels. All right, so while we're looking at stuff under the bonnet, I really want to touch on the dual battery system we've got going under here. We'll focus on more of the 12 volt setup when we jump around the back and have a look at the touring setup. But while we're under here, let's have a look. So we've got two Century batteries. The primary battery is a deep cycle Century, and the rear secondary battery is called a Century Dual Force AGM battery. As you can see, there's quite a bit going on here. We've run the BCDC unit from Red Arc that controls separating the batteries, the input from the solar panel on the roof. And then we've also ran what's called an SBI 12 from Red Arc as well. Now that's controlled by an in-cab switch, and that links the batteries in the case of a flat primary. Then you can get backup from your secondary so you're not stuck out bush with a car that won't start. All right, let's have a look around the outside of the car now. We'll cover some of the exterior accessories, and then we'll jump underneath and we'll have a look at the suspension, talk about the air lockers for a little bit, and yeah, really give you a walk around the outside of the car. So starting up the front of the car, as you can see, there's an ARB Sahara bar fitted. We've gone for a color-coded look against a black accessories, which you can see flow through the whole car. Complementing the bar, we've got two AR32 9-inch driving lights. This is the V2 version, so it's a bit brighter than their original intensity. We've also got two AR40 intensity light bars on the roof, so certainly enough light to do some night driving, which we plan on doing in the next few months. In the bar is a worn Xeon 10S winch with synthetic rope. We've used this plenty of times and it's been really reliable, couldn't recommend it more enough. LED fog lights from ARB. LED park and indicator lights, which was an upgrade for this model car. Now I've also gone with the Angel Eye headlight upgrade kit and coupled it with the steady LED globe replacement. It really complements the look of the vehicle and gives you a better performance while you're driving at night. Let's have a look around the rest of the car and see what else we've done to it on the outside. So we've got our ARB Deluxe side steps, coupled that with a textured black tread plate. These guys have stood up to a lot of punishment, and they have stood the test of time, really like the ARB side steps. Coming around to the back of the car, this is something I'm really excited to share with you guys. We've actually put an N80, which is the current model Hilux Summit rear bar from ARB, on the N70 model, like we can see. There was a bit of messing around. We had to weld a few brackets onto the wing panels, adjust how it mounted a little bit, but for the most part, it was a pretty easy fitment, and I really like the custom look of this. So a little bit about the bar. Obviously, they come factory with the N80 with rear parking sensors. We subbed these for some LED indicators instead. Because the N80 has a slightly wider tub, we fitted these tread plates instead to fill in that gap. And it also acts as a step for if you need to get anything off the roof or help you climb up into the tent as well. Now that's most of the exterior. I really want to show you underneath the car as well, see what we've done for suspension, under vehicle protection, and also talk about our air lockers for a bit as well. All right, so with a focus on remote area travel and with the car being super heavy, we really wanted to make sure we got a good suspension upgrade in there that can carry the load and also feel great when we're off-road.
So we went for the ARB BP51 suspension. That's a factory 50 mil lift. We then added a slight coil pack at the top of this to raise it about 3 inches in the front. The remote reservoir keeps the oil a lot cooler, so we can travel longer distances, and it still feels the same at the end of the day than it does when we first start. Complementing these front shocks, we've added the Old Man Emu upper control arms. That allowed us to push the caster forward a further 3 degrees and give us the clearance we needed in the back of the wheel arch to fit these 33-inch Mickey Thompson mud tires. So that's the tires. We wrapped them on a ProComp Series 69 alloy rim. Personally, really love the look of it, and they've really done us well for our trips around Australia in the past. Underneath the car, we've added our ARB bash plates. These are 3 mil thick steel, and as you can see, they've copped a beating, but most importantly, the stuff behind it hasn't. Well, that just as well wraps up the front end of the suspension. Let's have a look at the rear and see what's going on there. So the first thing you'll see as we jump under here are the 600 kilogram Old Man Emu leaf springs. We ran the 400s for quite a few years now, and they served their purpose. But as we depart on this slightly longer trip, we've literally got the kitchen sink inside of this thing, so we really needed to beef it up and went to 600s. We complemented this once again with the BP51 suspension, and something we haven't quite touched on yet are our air lockers. We run ARB air lockers front and rear, and honestly, they transform the IFS capabilities to something that's really capable off-road on some of the harder tracks as well. Now, before we wrap up the exterior of the car, I really wanted to touch on these clear view mirrors. Now, we all know clear view mirrors are quite big and long, especially when they're extended. We don't do a great deal of towing, so we chop them down, and that gives you the shortened look that you see here. There's a really good tutorial on how to do that on YouTube. Just jump online if you're interested. While we're in this space, this is the Safari Armax snorkel. It comes with a 4-inch air ram versus a standard 3-inch that you see on most of their other snorkels, and it actually modifies the airbox. When we fitted this, there was a cut and a hole in the airbox to really give you as much air into the engine as possible, and that really works well with our performance modifications and additional fuel that we've added. Let's go around the back and show you a little bit about our touring setup and what we've done with the back of the Ute. This is something I'm really excited to show you guys. Doing a lot of long-term touring, this is probably one of the most important things we've done to the car. We've tried to add all of the comfort that you would have in your own home into the back of a car without having to tow anything. So let's get into it. One thing to touch on as well, I want to give a quick shout out to Nick at Wrap My Ride. He's done a really good job with the vehicle signage on this car. Really ties in nicely. So if you need any vehicle signage done, go and see Nick. Before we open up the tailgate, this is the ARB cargo gear bag. Now, they only make this for the wagons or anything that suits a spare wheel. Obviously, we don't have one of these on here, so we modified it a little bit to work with the tailgate. And as you drop it, the bag swings out as well, so you can use it while you're cooking. All right, so you saw how easy that tailgate came down. That's an ARB Assist tailgate strut. We modified a Ford Ranger one to suit. Now, there's quite a lot to take in here. I'm going to start at the bottom and work our way up, and we'll cover everything in between. If you have any questions on this stuff, guys, please feel free to leave a comment, and I'll try and get back to it when I can. So we tinted all these windows for a bit of extra privacy and keep it cooler, especially when we're doing some of the more remote desert tracks. We've just opened up all these windows, let a bit of light in. So let's start with the sink and water system we've got going on here. We've got a 45 litre poly RV tank up the back there behind the drawers, coupled with a water pump fitted to the tank. That's all plumbed up to this guy here, which is our stainless steel fold up mixer tap. It runs hot and cold water. We'll go into the hot in a moment. But essentially, fold it up, turn the pump on, hot or cold, on it goes. This little guy here is a Top RG water monitor. It tells you how many liters are left in the tank at any given time, so you know you never run out of water. Going into the hot water system we were talking about before, we fitted the Julka hot tap. This is their version 2. Haven't had any problems with it so far. We might check in and do a bit of an update as we're traveling, but this is used for our sink, washing up, and also our shower setup that we'll show you in a moment. Now, talking about the drawers themselves, we've got two ARB roller drawers. The one on the left has a fridge slide top, and the one on the right we have our stainless steel table for any chopping up or organisation. In the right hand drawer, this is predominantly used for our pantry, any sort of food supplies and some spare parts. We've run all the ARB cargo gear organiser bags, keep things nice and tidy. And in the left drawer, this is our kitchen. And this is also something I'm really excited to show you guys. So this is a Dometic two burner gas stove. We've made sure it houses nice in the drawer so you can pack it away easily. This plumbs up to our gas bottle in the rear via a quick connect bayonet fitting. It's pretty self-explanatory, but this thing has been awesome on the road. Really quickly to cook as well, doesn't take a long time, and you can fit a pot and a fry pan next door to each other while you're cooking at the same time. Next thing is the fridge. This is an ARB Element 60 litre fridge, fitted to the rolling slide we talked about before. Really good bit of kit. If you're looking for a fridge, personally, I think the ARB has the best range. Now, one problem we faced when we were loading this thing up with a lot of camping gear is that some of the stuff could fall behind the fridge when you rolled it in and out. So we went and designed this rear rack and divider setup. This has been one of my favorite things we've done to the car. As you can see here, we've got all our spice rack, all our shelving on the side for any sort of knick-knacky bits and pieces. We've also got our Navigator organizers and MSA organizer bags fitted. And this houses things like our off-grid plumbing kit from Julka, our hoses, recovery gear, any sort of spare parts, those sort of bits and pieces. This has been a great asset in the back of the tub. Up the top, we also added a rear shelf. This holds things like our fishing rods, sand flags, rooftop tent ladder, and we've also added a few little bits and pieces here to glamify it a little bit. It holds our towels. We've got a magnetic rack here, which is used when we're cooking up, so you can put things like your tongs and your scrapers just on there. Keeps things, once again, nice and tidy while you're cooking, and personally, I think it looks really cool too. And this is where we've got the gas bottle. Because it's not inside the cab of the car, it's actually okay to have here. It's fitted using a Rhino Rack gas bottle ratchet strap holder. It keeps it nice and tidy. Because the windows are all tinted as well, it keeps it out of the elements, and haven't had an issue with it to date. So we said we'd go into detail about our 12 volt setup. As you can see here, there's quite a bit going on. We run a six-way fuse block here that powers most of our smaller accessories, like our water tank, our dimmable camping lights, our side lights, cigarette sockets, that sort of stuff. And then we've got our red arc 350 watt inverter fitted underneath this rear drawer panel, and that's powered on off with a remote switch on the side here. That's then wired up to this universal GPO outlet, and we've also got a two-way outlet up the top here if we need to charge camera batteries, drones, laptops, all on the go. Now, one thing that I am quite excited to show you is our air systems. So underneath this wing panel here, we've got a 4-litre ARB air tank, and that's plumbed up to our remote coupling hose connect here, and that's for inflating tyres. We've got a little blowgun here as well for doing any sort of cleanups around the place, or also helps lighting for hose as well. One of our absolute favourite accessories fitted to this Hilux has got to be the hot water rain shower. Now, sticking with the low profile design, we've managed to fit this underneath the Rhino Rack Pioneer platform. It was quite challenging to do, but I'm sure you'll agree the end result is definitely worth it. Two bungee cords to undo it. This is running heavy duty drawer slides, so we click these out and pull. And then the water inlet, we just connect to this quick connect hose fitting. Now, pairing on the hot water, we just run round to our Julka hot tap. There's a quick connect bayonet fitting that I'll just plug in now. Open the bottle, turn the pump on, and then we've actually gone to town and we fitted exterior hot and cold mixer taps to the car. One thing that bothered me a little bit with the standard Julka was that if it was too hot or cold, you had to go around to the unit, adjust the temperature control, and that would end up wasting a lot of water. So we can do this right here from the side of the car. Hot, cold. Takes a little bit of time to fill up the hose, and about 30 seconds for it to heat up fully. that can get all the way up to about 50 degrees.
For those that have done any sort of long-term touring, anything longer than 2 to 3 days, this thing is heaven. Especially some of the remote stuff when you're out in the desert or the high country where it's really dusty. Having a rain shower like this, just like you would at home, is really good. So you can see it start, well, you can feel it starting to heat up now. And then if you want to add any cold in, you just crack this one and it mixes it on the spot. I haven't seen anyone else do this yet, so I'm claiming it, but if you want to do this on your own rig, shoot me a message, I'll give you a few pointers. It really is one of the best things we've done in this car. All right guys, so shifting our focus upstairs, this is where we're going to sleep. We've opted for the Motop Series 4 hard shell rooftop tent. This has an aluminium shell and we really like the low profile design that it came with. On the exterior, we've added the optional roof rack kit and that houses our ARB Tread Pros. Inside, we've gone to town on a full 12 volt system. We've got a dimmable lights, we've got iPhone chargers, a iPad mount for any sort of movies you might want to watch. We've got a 12 volt fan in there as well, which we can dim for those hot nights up north. Because of the slimline design, they come with a self-inflating mattress. We've still kept that, but we've also added an additional mattress topper for a bit of extra comfort. This can house our duna cover and all bedding when we fold it up. The pillows we throw inside the car on a roof net, which I'll show you in a minute. But the tent itself is a really good bit of kit. If you like the look of it, get in touch with the guys at Motop. All right guys, so now we've looked at the back of the ute and had a good walk through our touring setup. I really want to take the chance to show you inside the car and have a look what we've done in here. Starting with the back, this is where we keep our clothes and those sort of things. We've got a lot of navigator gear. This is the Build It Pocket Buddy and the Build It Seat Buddy. These are a good bit of equipment for housing those things that don't really have a home. It keeps it nice and organized and they look great too. Under here we've got a Front Runner 40 litre water tank. This is a really good backup tank for us, especially when we're doing remote travel trips like the Simpson Desert. This is a good peace of mind and it also works well with our shower. So we can keep our 45 litre tank in here for our necessities, so drinking and washing up and cooking. And this extra 40 litres is great for that shower. Now one other thing to touch on in this back seat area is this rear roof cargo net. I got a shout out to Brandon Drosler. He helped me design this net. It's a really good place to house those pillows that we mentioned before don't fit in the rooftop tent when we close it up. All right, so jumping around the front of the car, there's a lot of tech going on here. So starting off with the pillar pod gauges, we run the 52 millimeter red arc gauge. This monitors our boost pressure, our exhaust gas temperature, and also ambient temperature. The bottom guy here is our digital speedometer. With the bigger tires fitted, the speedometer itself is thrown out a little bit, and that gives us an accurate reading. Moving across into the dash area, this is something we're pretty excited to show you as well. We've actually fitted an iPad mini into the head unit area, and this gives us all the apps like Hema Navigator, Netflix, Spotify, YouTube, Apple Maps, anything you can think of, it's all on this bit of kit here. So we've relocated the head unit into the glove box, so we still retain all the factory settings and power to the speakers, but this is a good bit of kit because it really gives you a lot of variety on applications that we can run. Moving down the dash, these are our 12 volt switches. So these pair a lot of the accessories that we talked about before. We've got our side lights, our front ARB intensities, our battery linkage, our ARB fridge monitor, and our wireless charging for both the phone and the iPad. This guy here in the fridge, that tells us what the fridge is doing back there, what temperature it's running, if it's got any fault codes, and make sure everything's traveling okay. Up here, we've got our Outback Solutions roof console, and fitted in that is a GME TX4500 radio. Keeps things nice and tidy, radio up above your head, and it's always easily accessible, especially with the magnetic microphone mount. Well, Well guys, that pretty much wraps it up. I'm sure there's plenty of stuff that we've missed off this thing. It's been an awesome build over the last 4 to 5 years, but if you have any sort of questions over the last 3 segments we've just covered, please feel free to drop a comment or shoot us a DM. We'll try and get around to it when we can. We're about to set off on this thing around up the middle of Australia and then around the west coast. So by the time you're watching this, we'll probably already be on the road, which is a pretty exciting feeling. If you see us, please say hello. And in the meantime, make sure you give us a follow at Overland Explorers. Thanks, guys.